Battle action in the West, says the commentator. The German front holds despite the continued Anglo-American offensive. The initiative in the West lies in German hands. The action dates back to the time when the Rundstedt counteroffensive regained some territory for the Germans. The high command had hoped to make great gains in this action. It has been learned that at no time did they ever reveal any specific objective to the soldiers put into the fight. The trespassing at this point was strictly forbidden by the British, but not to German soldiers, gloats the commentator. British and French captives are pointed out.
Das sind Soldaten der De Gaulle Armee.
This destruction is attributed to American mercenaries. Note the emphasis on religious desecration.
Auf den Straßen, die nach Westen führen, marschieren Panzer, Nachschub und unsere Grenadiere.
The Eastern Front. According to the commentator, this is an unidentified point at the beginning of the giant Soviet offensive along the entire front. He dates it January 13th. The Soviet communique dated it the 12th. There are indications that the Germans expected the offensive to begin about when it did and prepared for it. The gigantic proportions of the offensive are emphasized in the repeated statements that of the great amounts of equipment that have been destroyed, says the commentator. Uninterrupted battle from all German arms inflicted tremendous losses on the Bolshevist divisions. Flak, pack, and close combat against tanks play havoc with the Panzer giants. Behind cover and in foxholes, the German grenadier awaits the enemy with all arms. More than 1,000 tanks were destroyed within the first 5 days. The Soviets suffer heavy losses from the large-scale use of rockets.
Überall treten den bolschewistischen Massen deutsche Panzer und Infanterieverbände als Wellenbrecher entgegen. In hunderten von Dörfern toben schwerste Straßenkämpfe. Um jedes Haus, um jedes Waldstück wird erbittert gerungen. Panzergrenadiere werden zum Entsatz an eine Einbruchstelle geworfen. Die Front brennt auf 1000 Kilometer Breite. In den vorbereiteten Auffangstellungen sitzen die Grenadiere und lassen den Bombenhagel der sowjetischen Luftwaffe und Artilleriebeschuss über sich ergehen. Keine Nacht und keinen Tag mehr. Überall kann der Gegner sein. Überall treten ihm unsere Panzer und Grenadiere entgegen. Diese Tage und Wochen im Osten verlangen harte Herzen und harte Fäuste.
The Luftwaffe again in action on the Eastern Front, although somewhat timidly now. The comment is, weather conditions permitting, the infantrymen of the air, the fighter pilots, help their comrades on the ground. They attack a Soviet motorized column, and the tanks go up in flames under their heavy bombardment.
Schwarze Brandflecke im Schnee zeigen die Stellen an, wo die schweren bolschewistischen Panzer ihren Marsch nach Westen abbrechen mussten. Auf der unserer Erde aber geht der Kampf mit aller Härte und allen Waffen und in jeder Stunde weiter.
This item on the V2 from the January reel has been included to demonstrate how the Nazis continue to exploit every propaganda line to the last possible moment. The commentator explains, "We bring the first pictures of the V2s flying to England. For reasons of security, the pictures were taken from a substantial distance."
In rasender Geschwindigkeit steigt der schlanke Stahlleib in die Stratosphäre.
The path V2 leaves in the sky is still visible when the long-range missile has reached its goal, he says.